honor. If there's a game five, can you get a ticket for your brother?
Yins love
Randy Carlisle.
Yins love
Zarly Zalaski.
Yins love
Dan Quinn.
Yins love
Joey Mullen.
Yins love
Gino.
Yins love
Doug Wynn.
Hello there, everybody. My name is Jim Shear, and welcome to Yins Love Doug Wynn's. And you knew it was going to be a tough night for the San Jose Sharks last night when they marched out hometown heroes Metallica to do the national anthem, and it sounded like this. I kid. It was a joke. I actually enjoyed Metallica's rendition of the Star Spangled Banner. And truth be told, if the Penguins weren't in the Stanley Cup final, I would be rooting for the Sharks. It's hard to hate the Sharks. Easy to hate the Philadelphia Flyers, hard to hate the Sharks. That being said, if we want to bring the Stanley Cup back to Pittsburgh, we must defeat the Sharks. Let's go to the highlights. Halfway through the first period, Phil Kessel gives a lovely, lovely rebound to Ian Cole. Penguins lead 1-0. And no diss on Cole, but I think I could have scored on this one. In the second period, on a power play, Phil Kessel to Evgeny Malkin. Penguins lead 2-0. And how did we used to say it? Back alley Gino, up to no good. But you knew that the Sharks were going to make it close, and they did in the third. Melker Carlson on his knees, and his prayer is answered. The Sharks are only down by one. But late in the game, Haglund sets up Eric Fair. Penguins go up 3-1, and the Lemieux family loves it. As they say, all is fair in love and war. They also say, are you going to Scarborough Fair? No, I'm not. I'm actually going to Pittsburgh. I will see you there on Thursday. Penguins lead the series 3-1. Now, because we blew our entire budget on this palatial studio, we didn't have enough money to send Scooter Franklin to San Jose to cover game 4. I don't even think we have enough money anymore to cover his day rate. So we did the next best thing. I asked my friend Scott if he could shove a puppet into his carry-on luggage. He said yes. So covering game 4 for us are Yins Love the Gwyn's Yinsider, Bobo Bachman. Bobo, what was the atmosphere like in San Jose?
Well, it's fitting they play in the SAP Center, because as soon as the Sharks lost, the energy was sapped right out of the building.
Just to correct you, it's actually called the SAP Center.
If they want me to say SAP, they should have 3 periods, just like hockey.
Bobo, is that a bottle of wine?
No.
Were you going wine tasting in Napa Valley? You're not even in front of the SAP Center. You're in front of the Oracle Arena. Have you been watching the NBA Finals instead of the Stanley Cup?
No. I've been watching the Cup.
Okay. Who scored the game-winning goal last night?
Jordan Staal.
Let's forget about San Jose. Bring it back to Western PA. On Thursday, the Penguins can win the Stanley Cup. And if they do so, they'll be the first Pittsburgh sports team to win a world championship in Pittsburgh since this happened 56 years ago. Now, in all fairness, the Pittsburgh Penguins have never played in a game in which they could have won the Stanley Cup in Pittsburgh. In 2009, Game 7 was in Detroit. In 1992, Game 4 was in Chicago. And in 1991, Game 6 was in Minnesota. I want it to happen. And to ensure it does, I'm going to help out the Penguins with keys to victory in Game 5. Key number one, no guests. Earlier this year, Andrew WK was invited to Pittsburgh, the man who performs our goal song, Party Hard. He didn't get to hear a song because the Penguins didn't score a goal, losing to the Rangers. In Game 5 of the Tampa Bay Series, HBK, Heartbreak Kid Shawn Michaels, was invited to Pittsburgh. The Penguins lost, then trailed in the series 3-2, and the HBK line scored 0 goals. Even look at last night, San Jose invites Metallica to the game, and the Sharks lose. So just no guests on Thursday. And I would love it if the Penguins invited me to the game on Thursday. I could do a special episode of Yinz Love the Gwynns outside the Console Energy Center, but a key to victory is a key to victory. No guests. I'm going to take one for the team, and I will watch from home. Key number two. Actually, there's no key number two. Just one key to victory. No guests. If we follow that, we will win the Stanley Cup on Thursday night. It's that simple. That is going to do it for this episode of Yinz Love the Gwynns. If you need to get a hold of me, find me on social media at Jim Shear, or email me your lovely Pittsburgh Penguin picture at yinzlovethegwynns@yahoo.com. Until next time, my name is Jim Shear, and I will see Yinz later.